Your retirement should be a time for comfort and relaxation, not stress and anxiety over finances. Even if you're young, it's a good idea to invest for retirement to get a head start and increase the amount of your financial stability. However, investing can be difficult for some people, and that's why AARP's financial expert Rita Chang is back to help us understand how to start investing for our retirement so we can live and retire comfortably. Welcome back to the show, Rita.
Thank you so much.
So I'm so glad we're using this as a series to help people really understand how to plan for their retirement. And so the topic of this segment is investing. What different kinds of investing can we do to ensure a good retirement?
Sure. So we do want to invest and accumulate wealth so that we can have a good retirement. Mm-hmm. So today we're going to talk about the types of investments. We're also going to talk about how to choose investments. And then finally, the best vehicles that we should use to invest for our retirement.
What are the different kinds of investments?
So typically, the most common investments that we see in retirement plans are stocks, mm-hmm. bonds, and cash.
Right.
So stocks are what we like to refer to as higher risk, higher reward investments. Mm-hmm. When you purchase stock, you are purchasing ownership in a company.
Right.
So if the company does well, you know, you make money. If mm-hmm. the company doesn't so well, you could lose money.
Or if it goes belly up and bankrupt, that's trouble, right?
Right.
And then bonds are issued by the government.
Sure. So bonds are issued by the federal government mm-hmm. or local governments known as municipalities, and as well as corporations. So okay. companies can issue bonds as well.
Oh.
And they're not as risky as stocks, but they do still have some risk. With a bond, you are loaning someone money, mm-hmm. and in return, you get interest, and then at maturity,
you get the dividend.
You get your principal back.
Oh, you get your principal back. Okay, that's right. And then with cash, I mean, cash is pretty straightforward. You can put it under your mattress, you can put it in the bank, but it doesn't tend to really get a lot of interest on top of where you're putting it, right?
Sure. So as you mentioned, each investment, whether that's stocks, bonds, or cash, has an inherent risk.
Uh-huh.
So with stocks, they're going to be more volatile in the short term. Cash may not grow as much as you want over the long term. Mm-hmm. We're going to live a long time in retirement, so we
right.
need to make sure our money grows.
So is the smart way to invest then to pretty much find a good mix of all three so that you're making sure that you're risking enough that you're getting enough, good return, but also not risking it all so that you're ending up with nothing if something goes wrong?
Absolutely. So all these investments, stocks, bonds, cash, they're what we call asset classes. So depending on your appetite or comfort level risk will determine how much of each investment you want to have.
Mm-hmm.
So we all want to have our cake and eat it too.
Right. And I think it's worth mentioning that if you are in a 401k or like if you're an employee, chances are you are investing in the stock market already, correct?
Correct. So for many of you who do have employer sponsored retirement plans, 401ks, 403bs, you may not realize it or not, but you are investing in stocks and bonds, and you may be investing in mutual funds, which is a way of diversifying within those asset classes. So we talked about stock. The risk is if you pick one company and it goes out of business, you could lose your money.
Right.
Mutual fund, you're spreading the risk. It doesn't mean that you eliminate or remove all the risk, but you can reduce the risk.
What about our nation out there who, you know, either are retired already or maybe did not have the chance to invest in these vehicles the way they were supposed to, and they're watching this and they're like saying, oh gosh, I missed the boat. You know, I mean, how can you help people who are like that?
Sure. So for some people who may not have access to a retirement plan at their work, or maybe they feel like they're a little bit behind, they can open an IRA,
okay.
or an individual retirement account,
mm-hmm.
and they can start saving a modest amount on a regular basis. They can have the money taken out of their checking account,
mm-hmm.
So it's out of sight, out of mind, and they pay themselves first.
Okay, that's great. So what you're saying is really it's not too late. I mean, the best way to do it is to start young and do it while you're working, but if you're not working anymore or you don't have that means to do it, there's still a way, and you should still try to invest for your retirement.
Absolutely.
Okay, so if there's any more questions, I mean, I know this is a lot to take in and we could totally go down the rabbit hole and get into details about it, but if Arica Nation wants to learn more, is there a resource that AARP has to help them out?
Absolutely. They can visit aarp.org/money.
AARP Money. pretty easy to remember. Thank you once again, Margarita Chen, for joining us today, and I can't wait to see the other installments of this series.
Thanks so much.